Good morning, everyone. So in the last lecture, we have seen what is a neighborhood and how to find out the neighborhood with the examples. Okay, so neighborhood is a very easy concept in which you have to check only two conditions. For A to be neighborhood of a point X, we should say that first X must be a member of that A. And the second condition, there should exist a open set G which contain that point X and which is contained in A. Then only we can say A is a neighborhood of a X. So one example, and we have seen in which after that we have written some of the remarks, right? That is, if we are having the set A from toe, then we say that every point of A is a interior point of A, right? Every point of A is interior point. And we have seen that AC, one set we have taken, it is a neighborhood of A, but it is not a neighborhood of C, right? These things we have seen in the last lecture. Now let us go for the next definition, that is the boundary of boundary points of a set. Okay, up to now we have seen interior and exterior point. Now let us see what is a boundary point. So for defining the boundary point, first we should have a X2 is a topological space, right? We have X2 is a T space. Then let E be the any subset of X, for X belongs to capital A. X is called a boundary point of E. X is a boundary point of E. X is a boundary point of E. If X is neither interior point nor exterior point. If X is neither interior point nor exterior point. Okay, what do you mean by this? X to be a boundary point, it is not in interior as well as not in exterior. Right, just like imagine that you are sitting in the room. What is interior? The inside of the room. That means except wall, whatever there is there inside of the room, it is interior of the room. Right, and what is exterior? Whatever there is outside of the room. So in that case, you may come to know that we are not having any relation, that is we haven't considered a wall in interior as well as in exterior. So wall is considered as a boundary point. So just imagine the example of a room in which you are sitting. So in that, whatever there is inside, it is interior, and whatever there is outside, it is exterior. So whatever there in the boundary, that is your wall of the room. Okay, so the point is called, X is called a boundary point if it is not an interior as well as it is not an exterior point, right? So how we can define is, X is not an interior point as well as X is not an exterior point. So if I want to write down this, I can write this as X does not belongs to interior of A as well as X does not belongs to exterior. Right? Some of the element, if it is not in union, obviously it is not in both the set. Right? Because if it is there in at least one set, then it will be there in the union. Okay? So we can write from the above statement that X, if it is not a member of A interior as well as it is not a member of exterior, so we can say that instead of notation E is used. Okay, let us take the notation E only, E interior. Here also we take E interior. So if it is not a member of interior as well as exterior, it is not a member of the union. Okay, to be a member of union, it is it must be an element of at least one set. So X is belonging to where it will belong. From our definition of complement, I can write it will belongs to exterior or complement of this set, right? If I say that X is a member of A, obviously X is not a member of A complement. Or in another way, I can say if X is a member of A complement, X will not be a member of A. So what is a boundary point? Set of all boundary points are denoted by B of E. I can write the definition now as interior of E union exterior of A and its complement. So while defining boundary point, we should know what are interior point, what are exterior point, then take the union and take then complement, and then only you can find out what are the boundary points. Now let us go for the usual examples which we are taking. The first example which we take is a discrete T-space. Okay. So in case of a discrete T-space, first we will find out what is interior of E. In that case, let us assume E to be any subset of X, on considering E to be non-empty subset of X. First, we'll find out exterior of set E and exterior of interior of a set E. So what is exterior and what is interior? Interior is largest open set contained in E. Largest open set contained in E, and it is also largest open set contained in the complement of E, right? So we know that. What is the statement from this? I can write that E interior is contained in E, right? And we can say exterior of E is nothing but interior of E, its complement, right? How we define exterior? It is nothing but interior of E complement, largest open set contained in the E complement. That is nothing but interior of E complement. Now let us find out what is boundary of E. As we already know what is interior and what is exterior in case of this, so let me write down the definition of boundary point, that is interior of E union with exterior of E and its complement, right? So for that, what E interior union exterior of E is E complement, its interior and its complement, right? Now let me take this complement side inside and we get E interior, its complement, union will convert it to intersection, and we get E complement interior, its complement, right? So now what we are getting from this, whether this will be an empty set. If you remember, in case of a discrete T-space, we have studied that. What we have studied in case of a discrete T-space, that exterior of A is nothing but E complement, right? Why? Because every set is a open as well as a closed set, right? Because in case of discrete T-space, topology is nothing but family of a closed set which is equal to power set of X. So we can say the interior of E complement is nothing but E complement itself, right? Interior of E complement is nothing but E complement, or in another way we can write this as interior of E complement is equal to E complement itself. So you can write this region somewhere. Okay, I have to write this region here, A3 height. Okay, some of the students having the problem for this. So E interior, its complement intersection with E complement, its interior, I have written as E complement. So this complement, as it is complement of a complement, what is a set? It is a set itself. Okay, so we have E interior, its complement intersection with E. Now as we know that every set in the discrete T space is open as well as closed, so what will be E interior? It is equal to A if in case of we can say if and only if E is a open set. But we know that in discrete T space every set is open as well as closed. What do you mean by a set is open? It shows you that with the help of a theorem we can say E is open if and only if E interior is equal to E. So instead of writing E interior, I can write here as E, its complement intersection with E, and hence a set with its complement is a empty set. Right. So in case of a discrete E space, what I have got boundary points of E is a empty set. Right. So that's why you should know what are the properties of a discrete E space. Right. Whenever you come to know that what is a discrete E space. So first read 2 is equal to power set of X, which is equal to family K. So from this statement, you will come to know that every subset of X is a, or every member of 2 is a open as well as closed set. So hence we can write the those statement with the help of that we can write the result, right? So what is the result? If any set is if E complement is also a subset of X, now if E is a subset of X, obviously E complement is also subset of X, and we know that every subset of X in case of a discrete E space is a open as well as closed. So hence I have written this statement. So interior of the set is equal to the set itself, and here also if E is open, E is equal to E interior, right? So hence the result. Okay, now what we can write the remark for this: the boundary points for case of a discrete E space is empty set. Let us go for one more example, that is indiscrete E space. What will be the case in discrete E space? We know that what we know in indiscrete E space, we have 2 is equals to power pi and x. Let E be the any subset of X on condition E is a non-empty subset of X. So now again we have to write down the definition of interior as well as we have to write the definition of exterior. It is the largest open set in E, and this is the largest open set in complement of E. Okay, so you are having these two things. Now, if I want to write the definition of boundary points of E, before that we must know what is the interior of a E in case of indiscrete E space. Somewhere in the writing the properties of interior in that case, I have shown you with the help of an example and with the help of a proof that E interior in case of an indiscrete E space is a empty set. Why this is so? Because largest open set contained in E is phi itself, because X cannot be contained in E, right? E is contained in X, or E subset of X is true, but if it is not true, this X is not contained in E. How many open sets we have? Only two open sets. The first is phi, second is X. So what is the largest open set contained in E is a empty set. In the very similar way, what is exterior of a set E, which is nothing but interior of a E complement. Okay, if E is a subset of X, obviously E complement is also subset of X. And what is the largest open set contained in E complement? We are having only two open sets, phi and X. Which one is the largest open set contained in the E complement? E complement cannot contain X, right? X will not be contained in E complement. So hence we can say that now exterior of E is also empty set. So what is the boundary points of E? It is a combination of both, that is E interior union with exterior of E, then its complement, right? So this is also empty, union empty set, its complement. What is the complement of empty set? It is whole set X. So in case of indiscrete E space, what you can write the remark as: in case of indiscrete E space, we can say the boundary points of E is a X. In case of a discrete E space, boundary point of E is a equal to empty set. In case of a 2 is equal to power set of X is equal to family K. But here in case of indiscrete E space, that is only two open sets we have. That is phi and X. Okay, what is the largest open set contained in any set is a phi itself, because X is a universal set, right? So for that we are getting interior and exterior of any set is an empty set. If you are not getting the result, go back and you can understand the definition. Okay, what are the definition? Largest open set contained in E, largest open set contained in E complement. And what are the largest open set? Phi itself is the largest open set which is contained in E, no? Because X cannot be contained in E or E complement, because it is a universal set. we haven't defined. Okay, so hence we can say that boundary points of any set, any subset E in case of an indiscrete T-space is a whole set X. Okay, so these two remarks you can get from this. Now let us go for the many more results are there related to interior, exterior. I hope you can do it, or unless otherwise, if I have taken this already, June is ending and in the month of July I have to complete the syllabus. So अभी तक basic ही cover नहीं हुआ है तो syllabus कैसे cover होगा? That is what a question mark. Okay, let it go. जितना होगा उतना sufficient है, 80% syllabus. Let X to, but I will try my level best to complete the syllabus. No doubt it is not possible, but still from the first lecture we are trying this. Let X to be a T space, G be the any subset of X, but there should have a equal practice from you people also. You have to write down whatever written in every lecture. You have to prepare the notes on the same day. Then only you can prepare for the exam, because after completion of a syllabus itself, maybe in the and within 10 days you will have to appear for the theory exam. Even you have to prepare for the internal. In somewhere in the last lectures I have shown you that how many days you are remaining with that. Only 8 days. If you calculate from today, for every paper you have only 8 days, but it's still the syllabus to be done. That's why don't need to think that syllabus hone ke baad study karenge and all, right? Syllabus hone ke baad kuch bhi study karne nahi milega. G is open set in X if and only if G intersection boundary points of G is equal to empty set, right? Now let us go for the only if part. We have to prove this in the two parts. What is given to us? G is open in the first part, and we have to prove that G intersection boundary point of G is a empty set, right? If G is open, just like in case of discrete T-space, we have seen that if any set is open and closed, then we say that boundary points of E is a empty set. And in case of indiscrete T-space, boundary point of E is a whole set X. Okay, all are the boundary point in case of indiscrete T-space. But in case of discrete T-space, no point is a boundary point. Okay. सभी पॉइंट्स आइदर इनसाइड है या आउटसाइड है, बट बाउंड्री पे कोई भी पॉइंट्स नहीं है इन केस ऑफ डिस्क्रीट स्पेस. ओके, लेट अस गो वन बाय वन. दैट इज आई विल स्टार्ट विद द ओनली पार्ट. ओके, व्हाट इज देयर इन ओनली पार्ट? लेट अस अज्यूम जी बी द ओपन सेट. Assuming G to be open set, what do you mean by G is open set? G is equal to G interior. What is our aim to prove that? We have to prove that G intersection with boundary point of G is a empty set. Okay, interior means all the points which are inside, na? Largest open set contained in G. Okay, so we have to consider G to be an open set. So we are not going to consider the boundary points. The name itself suggests. Interior boundary, with the help of that you can prove the result, right? Now let us start with the result. What is our aim to prove? G intersection boundary of G, we have to prove it is an empty. So let us go by the definition of boundary points. What do you mean by boundary points of G? It is G interior union with exterior of G. It's a complement, right? Now we know that, what we know that G is open if and only if G is equal to G complement. You can write the reason here by the theorem in which we have written G is A is open if and only if A interior is equal to A. So I can replace here G, right? So now we can write interior of G complement by definition of exterior. Okay. Now if I apply the complement on this bracket, so I get it as G intersection with G complement. This union is converted into intersection. This will be interior G complement. It's a complement. Right? So what is G intersection with G complement? We know that any set with its complement is an empty set. Intersection with any set, empty set intersection with any set is a empty set. So hence the result, G intersection with boundary of G is a empty set. Okay. Those who want to see the result once again, you can repeat. Please see the YouTube lecture once again. Okay, let us go for the if part. Okay, what is there in the if part? We have provided that G intersection boundary of G is an empty set. Now our aim is to prove that. What is our aim is to prove? G is a open set. Okay, our aim is to prove that G is a open set, right? To prove G is open set, it is equivalent to prove that G is equal to G interior. Okay, now let us go for the proof itself. What is given to us? G intersection boundary of G is equal to empty set. In both the cases, we have to go with the statement. Okay, in the first way, we have proved LHS is equal to RHS. That means we have taken this part and we have proved it is equal to empty set. Now here, now again we'll make a use of a boundary of G. What is the definition of boundary of G? It is G interior union with exterior of G. It's a complement is equal to empty set. Okay, so as I hope you are knowing this, intersection B, if it is an empty set, I have explained you with the help of Venn diagram also how it is. Okay. A is contained in the complement of B and B is contained in the complement of A. This is only true in case of intersection of both the set is empty. So hence I can write in this case as, sorry, here it is G. So G is contained in, you can say it is G interior union with exterior of G. Its complement, whole complement. So complement and complement will be removed and B remains with the same set. Right? Complement remove hone ke baad kya bachega hamare paas? The set itself. Okay? I hope you understood this. This is what A intersection B is. Empty means what? A is contained in B complement. Yahan pe already complements hai. So complement will be a set itself. Complement cancel hot nahi. Somewhere we have written A is A bar, its bar is A bar. So bar bar cancel nahi hota hai. A complement, its complement is A. No doubt it is true in case of A complement. Okay. Now what is our aim to prove? G is a open set, right? So if I want to prove that G is a open set, right? What do you mean by G to be open set? If I want to prove G is a open set, we have to make a use of this statement. G is open if and only if G interior is equal to G, right? But what is an always true statement? I am writing many times always true statement. What are the always true statement? I can say G interior is contained in G is a always true statement, right? Okay, you can name it as equation 1. G interior is contained in G is always true statement. So if I want to prove G is equal to G interior, what I have to prove? G is contained in G interior. What is equation 2? Equation 2 tells us that G is contained in G interior union exterior of G, right? So if I prove this one, G is contained in only G interior, right? If I want to prove that, if I prove this one, G is contained in G interior, the result hold. Both are contained in one another and hence they are equal. Right. So from equation 2, what I have to prove? G is contained in G interior only. That is to prove that. Okay. That is to prove that G is not contained in exterior of G. And if I prove that G is not contained in the exterior of G, the result hold. Right. Now from equation 2 we have derived. अगर इक्वेशन टू में हम जी इज कंटेन इन जी इंटीरियर ही बोलते हैं राइट देन इफ यू प्रूव दैट जी इज नॉट कंटेन इन एक्सटीरियर ऑफ जी द रिजल्ट ऑब्वियसली होल्ड दैट मीन्स अवर इक्वेशन जी इज कंटेन इन जी इंटीरियर होल्ड एंड वी गेट द result. Okay, so proving this, let us assume the contradiction. Okay, to prove that G is not contained in exterior of B, it is somewhat difficult. So what is our claim now? Our claim is to prove that G is not contained in exterior of G. Okay, so we will prove the result by contradiction. If possible, assume that G is contained in exterior of G. Okay, so which means that G is contained in interior of G complement, right? But we know that, A interior is always contained in A, okay? Whatever may be the set. Now, if A is replaced by A complement interior is contained in the A complement. Set koi bhi ho, either it is complement A, B, C, whatever it is. G is contained in interior of G complement, and in every interior of the set is contained in the set itself. You should know this property. A interior is always contained in the A. A काय पण असू शकतो इथे, G complement असू शकतो, कुठलाही set असेल. Okay, every set contains its interior. And which implies prime transitivity, I can say G is contained in G complement. And which is contradiction? राईट ना, जी कधी जी कॉम्प्लिमेंट मध्ये असतो का? दोन्ही डिसजॉइंट सेट असतात ना. अँड दिस कॉन्ट्रडिक्शन अराइजेस ड्यू टू द रॉंग अझम्पशन दॅट जी इज कंटेन्ड इन द एक्सटीरियर ऑफ जी. राईट, सो दिस वॉज अ रॉंग अझम्पशन, अँड हेन्स वॉट शुड बी द राईट अझम्पशन? जी इज कंटेन्ड इन द जी इंटीरियर फ्रॉम इक्वेशन 2, अँड हेन्स द रिझल्ट. जी इंटीरियर इज ऑलवेज कंटेन्ड इन जी, हे तर ऑलवेज 2 स्टेटमेंट आहे. So combining these two statement, I can say G is equal to G interior, which implies G is a open, whether it is an if and only if statement. Okay, so many more results are there related to interior, exterior, right? I hope you will do it because time is not allowing us to take all of this result. Okay, I will simply write down all those properties somewhere from the notes or from Shivaji University, though you can take down this. No doubt it is important, but still we have to go for actual syllabus of topology. Interior of E is equal to E complement, closure, complement. This is important property. Somewhere in the next thing we are going to use it. So remember this property and try to write down the result from somewhere in the notes of Shivaji University or in the book of K.P. Gupta, you can get the result. The next is boundary of E can be E bar intersection with E complement, it's a bar. Okay, so boundary of E can be defined in another way as E bar its complement, E bar intersection with E complement bar, right? So you have to start with the definition of boundary point and you have to prove that it is equal to E closure intersection with E complement closure. Rather, I will give you this as a first assignment so that everyone will do it. First assignment is completion of all these properties. Okay, no doubt somewhere you are going to get these properties. The notes that I have shared you, Shivaji University notes and K.P. Gupta book, from all these books and notes you can get the result, and it will be practice for you people also, and our syllabus will be going ahead. What is boundary of E? We can say it is E closure intersection with E complement, it's a closure. Next, some of the properties I can say is, first one is interior of E intersection with boundary of E is a empty set. Why this is so? Just now we have proved the result, no? What is the result? We have proved G intersection with boundary of a G is a empty set if and only if G is a open. Okay, what is interior? Interior is a largest open set. So before being a largest open set, it is first low open set. So open set intersection with the boundary is obviously empty set. So this theorem we have already proved. So you can prove the result easily. I hope you can understand from this. यहाँ पे जो theorem हमने अभी जो prove किया है ना, G is open if and only if G intersection with boundary of G is a empty set. So instead of that, it is having a interior. Okay, interior is a largest open set. Before being a largest, it is firstly open set. Open set intersection with a boundary is a pi, na? Okay, next is we have to prove the result. I think you have to prove. Exterior intersection with boundary of E is also empty. The name itself suggests boundary with exterior. Exterior matlab kya? Room ke bahar ka hissa. Right, so दीवार रूम के इनसाइड भी नहीं होता है, आउटसाइड भी नहीं होता है, सो इट इज वॉल. सो एक्सटीरियर इंटरसेक्शन विद द बाउंड्री इज एम्प्टी. दिस रिजल्ट यू हैव टू प्रूव. अ थर्ड रिजल्ट दैट यू हैव टू प्रूव इज बाउंड्री ऑफ ई कॉम्प्लीमेंट एंड बाउंड्री ऑफ ई बोथ आर इक्वल. ओके, सो यू हैव टू स्टार्ट विद, व्हाट यू हैव टू स्टार्ट विद, बाउंड्री ऑफ ई कॉम्प्लीमेंट. यू हैव टू स्टार्ट, मेक अ यूज ऑफ द statement that I have shown you now, and then prove it is equal to boundary of E. Okay. Any more results are there after this about interior, exterior, boundary and all, and after that we are going to have the basis and subbasis, and after basis and subbasis we will have separation axioms, and from there only we are going to start the syllabus. Okay, now let me take the one example on boundary points so that your ideas will be clear how to find out the boundary points. It x is equals to a comma b comma c. A2 is equals to 5x singleton A singleton B AB. To find out boundary of E, that is our question is to find out boundary of E, right? So what is E? We have been provided E to be a comma C. So first let me find out E complement, that is nothing but B. Okay. So how to find out boundary of E? First you have to find out interior of E. What is the largest open set contained in AC? That means you have to find out one set which is contained in AC and which is largest one. Okay, I can say singleton A itself is the largest open set contained in AC. So I can say interior of E is equal to singleton A, largest open set contained in AC. Okay, what is E complement? A, which is nothing but interior of E complement, sorry, exterior. This is exterior of E is interior of E complement, right? So what I can say, exterior of E is nothing but interior of singleton B. What is the largest open set contained in the singleton B? Okay, how many open sets we have? There is many open set. What is the largest open set contained in the singleton B? Is a singleton B itself, and hence the result. I can say exterior of E is a singleton B itself, and interior also we have calculated. Now simply we have to find out boundary of E is equal to exterior union with interior. It's a complement, right? AB cha complement ka yenar hai C, right? So hence we get the boundary of E is a C. Or in another way, we can prove the result by the one more definition. What is the one more definition of B of E we have written just now? It is E closure intersection with E complement. It's a closure, right? So with the help of this also, I will prove the result. This we have proved with the help of a definitions. So what we get the result is singleton C. Interior complement, interior exterior of E, and its complement is a C. Result by using this, so we can say 2 is equals to I x What is ha we having? A is B, AB. So to prove the result by using this condition, we should know firstly what are the closed sets. So what is a complement of phi x? How to find out the family of a closed set? Simply it is complement of members. So complement of x is phi. Complement of A is BC. Complement of B is AC. Complement of AB is C. So here we get the family of the closed set. Right? What is E? We have A. E is provided to us as AC. Right? E complement ka NRM out. So E complement will be B. Okay? So what will be E bar? E bar is the largest open set, smallest closed set containing AC. Smallest closed set containing E. E को contain करने वाला smallest closed set चाहिए ना, because we know the relation E is always contained in E bar and E interior, A interior is always contained in E. Right? Then repeatedly I am writing these relations so that you can remember at least. Okay, what is the smallest closed set contained in E? What is E? AC. What is the smallest closed set contained in AC? AC mein contain karne wala smallest closed set containing AC. Okay, AC itself is the smallest closed set containing itself. So I can write E closure is equals to AC itself. Right? No? Smallest closed set containing E. Okay, we have to find out the closed set which contain AC, smallest closed set. Right? So what will be the set? It is AC itself because it is there in the family of a closed set. Ahe na family of closed set madhi. In a very similar way, we have to find out E complement. It's a closure by new definition of boundary of E. What is boundary of E? E closure union V, E closure intersection with E complement closure. Okay, what I can write here? Smallest closed set containing E complement. Okay. Which means what is the smallest closed set containing B, singleton B is contain karne wala smallest closed set kaun sa hai, right? What we can say from here? Can I say this to be BC? Smallest closed set containing B is a BC. So I can write here as B, C. X is also there, but we have to find out the smallest one. So we can get this as a BC. So combining these two, what is the definition? Boundary of E is equal to E closure intersection with E complement closure. That is equal to E closure is AC intersection with E complement closure is. What is E complement? It's a closure. We have got it as BC. What is a common point in between these two is a C. Adi pan aplyala answer C bhetla hota na by definition. You can see here. What is the answer we have got is a singleton C. Here also by another definition we got the same answer. So write one example for the homework. Today you will have many much more homework to do. I don't know how many of you are going to complete this. This is for you because already I have passed the topology. Okay, this is what a topology is equal to AB You have to find out boundary of E from both the definition. Check from both the definition. First is a definition, second one is E closure intersection with E complement. It's a closure. Okay, next is boundary of E union with interior of E. What I get? E closure. This property you have to prove. Next property you have to show that is boundary of A intersection, sorry, boundary of A union B is contained in boundary of A union with boundary of a B. Okay, you have to prove this result. Just start with this and prove this. Okay. कुठे सबसेट येणार आहे, काय प्रॉपर्टी यूज करणार आहे बघा. हा नेक्स्ट काय, दिस वी हॅव ऑलरेडी प्रूव्ह दिस इन दॅट केस ऑफ डिस्क्रीट टी स्पेस, दॅट इज बाउंड्री ऑफ ई इज एम टी इफ एन ओनली इफ ई इज बोथ ओपन अँड क्लोज. इन केस ऑफ डिस्क्रीट टी स्पेस वी हॅव सीन दिस ना, जर तुमचा सेट ओपन आणि क्लोज दोन्ही असेल तर बाउंड्री पॉईंट एम टी सेट येणार. सो यू हॅव टू प्रूव्ह दिस रिझल्ट. इफ ई इज बोथ ओपन अँड क्लोज, वॉट डू यू मीन बाय ई इज ओपन? E interior is equal to E. What do you mean by E is closed? E closure is equal to E. So by proving these two, we have to prove the result. What you have to prove? Boundary of E is a empty set. If and only ahe, and ek part madhe prove kela tari pan okay. Okay. So many more properties are there. You can also go with those properties. In the next lecture, that is on the Monday itself. And so I want to tell you one thing, most probably every Sunday I will take one lecture or at least a recorded lecture. मी कधी पण बघू शकता संडेला, when you are, whenever you are available, you can see that lecture, recorded lecture. So this theorem we have to prove is that X2 is given to be a T space. X star 2 star B, it's a subspace. I hope everyone knowing relative topology, subspace topology माहिती असेल. सबस्पेस आणि रिलेटिव टोपोलॉजी नसेल तर सोमवारी स्टडी करून या, सो दॅट आय विल बी इझी फॉर यू. सो एफ स्टार इज कंटेन्ड इन एक्स स्टार. एफ स्टार इज अ क्लोज्ड सेट इन X star 2 star if and only if F star is equal to, what is F star? F intersection with X star for some closed set F, for some closed set F which is in F to be closed set in X2. हे थेरमचे स्टेटमेंट आधीच्या लेक्चरमध्ये का लिहिते मी, बिकॉज ॲट लीस्ट यू शूड अंडरस्टँड वॉट यू वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर. आणि थोडंफार तुम्ही अभ्यास करून या, काय असणार आहे एफ स्टार हे क्लोज सेट. सबस्पेस टोपोलॉजी माहीत पाहिजे, एफ हे क्लोज सेटचे प्रॉपर्टीज माहीत पाहिजे, दोन ओनली वी कॅन go for this relative topology वगैरे. Okay, so in the next lecture we are going to prove these result and then we'll go for basis and subbasis and then we'll start for our TI space nomenclature. Okay, I will see number of views on the Sunday for my YouTube lecture.